Alrighty guys, so we are starting off in Creative Fabrica, and in Creative Fabrica, I think this is actually going to be really a useful tool for those who have the pro version and those who don't have the pro version. So I have the pro version, but if you don't have the pro version, which is if you don't have the membership, I will have a link below where you can just get started with it for free. So we're just going to start off with Studio, which is Creative Fabrica's new studio where you can create your designs for just whatever it is you want to use. So we're just going to do a full walkthrough of it, and it's my first time actually doing a walkthrough of it, so I'm actually really, really excited to show you guys how to do it. So you just want to start off by just going through here, and Studio is just actually just a really great tool for everything, and I'm just going to show you how to do that now. So you just want to start off by going to design now, and it's just going to open up a whole new page for you, and they have all sorts of just great things for you, and it's depending on what your niche is or if it's for personal use. So you just want to either do new project or create a design. It just really depends on where you want to start. But like I said, I'm starting off fresh and raw for you guys. This is just a full walkthrough and introduction to Creative Fabrica's new studio. So once you get to this page, like I said, I haven't done anything beyond this point. And like I said, I don't know if you guys ever have seen me do anything of tutorials where I use my computer, but my computer is just really slow, so forgive me. But once you get to this page, you're going to see what's popular for this week, and you can see all of the like invitations or birthday signs, postcards. So if your niche is anything birthday, like if you make a lot of if you are making graduation things, because graduation is coming up, graduation is a really great niche. That is really a cool template as well. But as far as like birthday things, like birthday banners or birthday cards, if you're into custom party favors, those are great niches as well that are on here. And they have a lot of good templates to use. And I'll show you all of those templates as well. So you just want to add a new design, or you can do it up in the right-hand corner as well. And they have all sorts of different just design sizes. So a postcard, a calendar, a flyer, a poster, bigger posters. So then you want to go to print sizes. So if you're doing anything landscape size or portrait, if you're doing anything with just journals or labels, which is pretty cool. Labels could be if you're labeling like jars or whatever the case may be. So they have like all sorts of things here. And like I said, you don't have to be in a niche. It could be just for personal use, like notebooks. If you're doing stationery, anything in that niche is actually pretty cool as well. So we go to craft projects. So mugs, which is for me, if you're into sublation, or acrylic tumblers, if you're doing vinyl wraps, those are really cool as well. If you're into epoxying, so that's really awesome as well. They have a whole bunch of different things, as well as scrapbooking. If you are into scrapbooking, wine tumblers, I thought that was really cool because I do wine tumblers, and they actually have wine tumblers where you can make a template for it and do vinyl wraps for wine tumblers. So I might make a video on that. Let me know. But print on demand. So if you have a print on demand store, that's actually pretty cool. They have templates for that, for t-shirts, for Amazon merch, for stickers, for anything in that sort of realm that you have, or just like I said, for personal use. Social media, if you are a social media influencer or a social media content creator, they have different things of that sort where you can make just reels or Facebook reels, or if you have a group, a private group, if you use WhatsApp to just connect with your family and friends, like if you have an Etsy shop, or if you're a Creative Fabrica if you are an affiliate with Creative Fabrica, same thing with just emails or ebooks. If you sell ebook products, or if you're trying to make an ebook, that would be pretty cool. So this actually is really great. You know, they give you a really wide range, and just to get started as well. Like I said, you can get started with it for free. Here is just wedding templates. So if you're in the wedding niche, they have wedding invitations, they have cards, envelopes, or if you're making your own wedding invitations or wedding materials, here you can come here and make your own wedding materials, and you don't have to pay anything. The things that, like the elements, the graphics, and all of that may be limited because it may be for pro users, but you can still use the resources on here. These are for businesses, so business cards, stickers, presentations, letters, that sort of thing. So if you have a business, you can make your own business cards, which is pretty nice because you don't have to pay to go make your business cards for some, or have someone make them for you. You can make them yourself. So we're just going to use a random document so I can show you the other items or materials that Creative Fabrica Studio has to offer. So I was just trying to, like I said, this was my first time in here, so forgive me. So I was just trying to figure out on the side here. So on the right hand side, you have in the unit, you have inches, millimeters, centimeters, that kind of thing. You have your orientation, which is your landscape and your portrait. And you have your width and your height, that kind of thing. And then you can do your create new design. And I went with just the mug design there, and then you just create a new design. So for the purpose of this, I just went with the mug 3x3 inches, just so I can show you the different templates, AI graphics, and all of that good stuff. So on the left hand side, they have all of the different things in the resources that you can use here, and I think it's pretty cool. So for templates, this is all the templates that they have that you can use if you are wanting to do whatever it is. So if you are wanting to make a social media graphic template, or a t-shirt, or if you are wanting to do a postcard or an Instagram or anything really, it would be here. You can, the possibilities are endless here. And you just come back over to the left-hand side in AI. This is AI. So with AI, if you are having a hard time finding a graphic or anything like that, you would type in, for instance, I typed in, I think, flowers with a blue background. And you would type in flowers with a blue background. And once you type that in and create an image, the AI would automatically generate that image for you. So it can really be anything, as long as it's, you know, it's concise with whatever it is you're trying to generate through there. So with graphics, you can search anything through with graphics. It pulled just about whatever it is that I wanted, but with graphics it's so hard to choose just because they looked it so good. So it took me a while to find what I wanted. So once I was happy with what I found, you just want to select whatever graphic you want, and you can keep this one graphic here, and which is nice because they have all sorts of things in with the graphic. Or let's say you are making a Tumblr, right? And you wanted to do sort of a seamless Tumblr, you would come here on repeat on background, and it repeats it for you so many times. And I forgot to show you this, but it repeats it here 4 times. But let's say you wanted to remove that. You would just click on it, and on the right-hand side, it would pull up a layers panel for you. But let's say you wanted to make that smaller. It would pull it up however many times it duplicated that image. That is pretty awesome because you don't have to repeat duplication so many times and then sit there and try to center it so many times. Because when I try to center an image so many times, it just never works. It never works and it sucks. So that's what that graphics tool is, that little tool is, and it's just so amazing. It really is. It helps. So if you're trying to do a vinyl wrap and you want a really cool design that you just can't find on a website or at the store, you can print this off on vinyl sticker paper and slap it on a tumbler and put epoxy or crystallac or bright tone or whatever it is you want to use. And there you go. There you go. So we're going to move on to text. And with text, they have their own fonts that you can use and make it kind of your own. And they also have at the top here, heading, subheading, and body. So you can add your own text here so you can make it kind of big. And they have like paragraphs, that kind of thing. They have transparency. So they have their own kind of fonts, which is really nice. They have like transparency, like I said. They have down here, you can make it bold. They have like different italic sizes. You can change the color, which is pretty cool. And then as well, they have where you can do border heights, and you can make it a different kind of border heights, and you can kind of make your own fonts your own kind of style. So if you wanted to do an outline, you can do that as well. So that's pretty cool. And I don't know if you can bring in your own fonts. That's something that I didn't play around with, but I'm not really sure. But that is the font. So for elements is just if you want to spruce up kind of your design. So if you're doing something for a customer, or if you're doing kind of a custom party favors, because that's kind of the only thing I can think of. But if you're doing just something that you just need to do something for, this is what elements is for. And I really didn't get a chance to really just go in depth with it, but this is kind of what that is, what you can do with it. So now we're moving on to photos. So with photos, if you are just looking for a background, they have all sorts of photos that you can make your background. So we just had Valentine's Day, so they still have some Valentine's Day images. They also have kind of like the sky. And with this one, you can also do a duplicate of a background as well, which is nice. And you can also make these like sublimated, or if you want to do these as a vinyl wrap, or these can also just be personal. So these can be backgrounds on your phone. These can just be whatever you want them to be. So they have a heart, sky, sky heart, or heart and sky, which is pretty cool. So, and I was also wanting to just type in kind of like Easter. They have Easter background images because, you know, Easter is a month away, which is pretty crazy. So they have Easter, and I wanted to kind of type in Mother's Day. They didn't have a whole bunch for Mother's Day, which is fine, but, you know, I wanted to at least try and kind of see what they had. And that's what they have for Mother's Day. But I think they just have more so just the overall kind of things that you can use for your background. So this is more so your width and your height. And I wanted to do more so my own background and make a mug. So this is what I wanted to do and show you guys how I did it. And this is what it came out to be. And I actually really, really liked it. So I ended up making my image to be 8.5 by 11 inches because that was the width and height of my paper, because I was using simulation paper. And then I ended up putting it in my convection oven, and this is what the results ended up being. But once you do all that, you just want to download it and save it as a PDF to your computer. And this is what it ended up looking like once I was able to do all of that, and I'll show you kind of how I did it, and I won't speed it up. I'll just put some music on and just show you how I did that. Once I was done, I did save this as a PDF. So you just want to go up to the right hand corner to share, and then you want to click on it. And I had to click on it multiple times, and then you just want to download it. And it's going to give you different ones, a PNG, JPEG, or a PDF. Anything that you're getting ready to send to your printer, you want to do and save as a PDF, just because that's kind of, it just is easier. So you just want to save it as a PDF. And I didn't realize it, that I was sending it to my documents twice. So this is what it looks like once it is saved as a PDF. And this is what it looks like after I put it in my sublimation oven. And I did have some issues. I had some ghosting, and that's partly on my error, so I do need to work on my taping. But other than that, I actually really, really enjoyed this. I thought it came out so beautiful, and I really do like the different designs that Creative Studio has. They have some intricate designs, and I also didn't like how it was sideways, so I need to work on my orientation. So, but I do still have some of this design left. So if you do want to see how I did this differently, just check out my different social medias below, and I will link that below. But other than that, I really do like this mug. I'm going to keep it for myself, but let me know what you guys think. It is a great beginner-friendly studio to get started with. Like I said, you don't have to have the membership. You do get to use it as a beginner, and it's free. So just try it out, and you don't have to have a niche. You don't have to have a small business. You can just do it personal and just do it just to do it. But the colors are vibrant. They came out really, really good. But I do love this, and I hope you guys like the tutorial as well. And I hope you guys like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you in my next video. But yeah, I'll see you guys later. And my posting times are Wednesday and Saturday, so don't forget that. And, yeah, I'll see you guys soon. Bye.